I do realize that people are still arriving, so I will give them a few moments to do so. Balados, everyone, for appearing today. If there is anyone out there, you can drag them in. Because, yes, I'm only doing an hour for the row, and so it will be mostly Q&A. Because after that, I've been asked to teach a class on the drow, Doc Elfar, which is most excellent because that is one of my favorite things to talk about. And we will continue, we will do that right here. So all of you are welcome to stay for the second class. I'm perfectly fine with that. So go ahead and check your friendship list right now. See if there's anybody out there that should be dragged in. Because it's for everyone. It's not just for leaders. It's not just for combat players. And yes, as Magister... Mage Hunter Nifredil... Yes, I know. I have called you Magister Apprentice twice now. My apologies. I guess someday I may have to promote you just so that I'm not wrong. Okay. Yes, actually. Get with me later. I might end up doing that. Anyway. In just a few moments, I will begin. Start collecting your questions, because mainly it's going to be a Q&A. I will talk about a few things, especially the Deep Rose runs, because I am aware that people are still not really understanding what their purpose is. A lot of people are still thinking, oh, that's only for the level 5s to run up there and find stuff and make themselves better. But that is not the case. And so I want to talk a little bit about that. Let people know what the icy reasons, for the Deep Roads are, and what the Deep Roads are across the board. I will give them 4 minutes to arrive. Well, if you think Dragon Age, you're not entirely off base. You are, but you are not entirely. Because the name does mirror the Dragon Age version. And it is full of dwarven artifacts and dwarves and a lot of bad things. However, yes, we don't need to use that in public. And yes, that phone was mine. That would have been Valsharis Coyote. But I can't answer right now. I will call her back. Now, the Deep Roads. At one time, there was a massive empire about 200,000 years ago under the Terran, under Terra, which is where you guys all reside, where everyone resides. It had been in place for a good 300,000 years before it was mostly destroyed. When it was destroyed, it was the Dark Elfar Empire, by the way. When it was destroyed by the Illithid, the deep dwarves came through and repaired it as much as they wanted or needed to, because there was not a need to repair the whole thing. They used it for trade and to get from city to city and up to the earth, up Terra. So they repaired parts of it, the parts that they felt necessary. It has become the home to a vast array of beings, most of which are villains. Chief among those would be the Illithid. The Illithid, some of you know them as Mind Flayers, Squid Heads, at one point tempted to, or three major points, but we shall say, at one point they attempted to take over the plane. They are chaos beings, and they got a taste of what the plane of order offered. Now, to a chaos being, the plane of order offers things like a physical manifestation, gravity, inertia, touch, taste, things that they could not have in the plane of chaos. Now, over the next 300,000 years, they developed a craving for those things, and they attempted to, on several occasions, to take over Terra. Well, they were driven back each time by the Dark Elfar. But the last time, that the cost to the Dark Elfar, the Drow Elves, was massive. Ninety 90% of their empire and of their people were destroyed. That is why Drow Elves are so rare, because the Mind Flayers and their foot soldiers, known as Metaliki, and all of the mind-controlled creatures, which have a vast array, almost won. They didn't, obviously, but they almost did. They are back. A wee bit ago, one of their chief operatives, known as a Tal Maru, came to the Terran plane in disguise and studied to be a mage. At that point, they attempted to take over this with the 200,000 years ago. At that point, they attempted to take over the Terran plane again. They lost, but they brought about the Metaliki. They were banished at that point, and they have been gone for all that time. Recently, two individuals were thrust into oblivion, which is another name for the plane of chaos. And when that happened, it awakened the lust for the Terran plane, the plane of order, once again. Now, they still were feeding on it, because the Tal Maru kept telling them, oh, we got to do this, we got to do this, we got to do this. But you know what? When you stop seeing a thing, you forget about it, right? Well, when they encountered those two physical beings that possessed bodies and were affected by inertia and gravity and could touch and taste and smell, it awakened that lust once again in them. So they began to forge forward once again, not just under the words of a Tal Maru. And so even though they were already planning and they were already doing things to try to get here, it really upped their desire to be here. Consequently, when a Tal Maru pierced the realms, and with him or her came a vast array of villains, many of which who bypassed the waiting forces. A lot of them stayed and engaged, but not all of them. A lot of them escaped deep into the deep roads, because light is not pleasant for Illithid. Light hurts them a great deal. That's why they were trying to get into the what is commonly called Underdark. But the deep roads are far below that. So that's why they were trying to get into the deep roads, because it's dark. Yes, it has its own light, but it's not, it's an ambient form of light. It's not like where you are standing right now. So a lot of them pierced into the deep roads. And stayed there. And they have been making incursions into Terra as often as they could. Well, one day, the Blood Knights, because their job is to keep the Chaos Forces at bay, were out exploring, and they found one hole at that time, into the deep roads. And they investigated and found out that it was possible to go down into the deep roads. So the collected forces of the shadows and the light got together, and as sounds obvious, I call them the shadow light forces. So the shadow light forces came together and decided to start taking the battle to the enemy, instead of always waiting for them to come up here. Now, they had done damage each time they were up here. They destroyed one of the Sovaran cities at that time. And the area was rebuilt. But the combined forces decided, rather than let them come up here every time and destroy things, we should go after them. Now, that is a very, very dangerous decision, but it has been fairly unanimous. So, in the large-scale battles that we have, large amounts of the shadow light forces go into the deep roads and try to take out the Illithid. And collect what they can while they're there. On smaller scales, however, several small parties of adventurers have been getting together because it has been discovered that in the deep roads there still resides many metals and magic items that have laid abandoned, relatively untouched, for the last 200,000 years. Those small parties, those adventurers, are the Deep Road's crawlers. And a Deep Road crawler can be any single individual in the Great Alliance. I don't recommend going up there by yourself. That is why they have the dungeon crawls. A group of, you know, four or five players get together and go on a dungeon crawl. The black market has benefit from such, because there are still many items up there, and metals, ores, that are not located anywhere else. Okay? Some of the more common ones are still located there too, of course. That's correct. But it's fairly exclusive to some of the more rare ones. Now, consequently, yes, most of the deep roads are dwarven in construction, because they rebuilt them. But a lot of them are still ancient elven, from the days when the Dark Elven Empire was actually a thing. So you're going to find architecture of both varieties up there. Sometimes intermingled. The drought built a city and it got destroyed. The dwarves decided to come along and say, all right, this part of the city I'm going to rebuild because I need to get over to point A and I'm at point B. So we're going to rebuild this part of the city. Okay. We need a road. That's why they became known as the Deep Roads. That was not their original name, but because that's what the dwarves have decided to use them for, they became known as the Deep Roads. Any questions thus far? Okay. All right. So, continuing on with the deep roads, then I'll talk a little bit more about it, and then I will let you guys ask a variety, whatever questions you have, and about whatever, because I am not going to go quite as far as normal. since I will be talking about dark elves here in about 45 minutes, thereabouts. All right, something else about the deep roads. When you get up there and you find things, just because it doesn't mean anything to you doesn't mean it won't mean something to someone else. Many of you have heard me say, if you see that lead pipe laying on the ground, just because it, to you it's just a lead pipe, doesn't mean that somebody else might have use for that. There are a lot of quest items in the deep roads. And you look at them and you think, this is nothing. This is a piece of paper. This is a lead pipe. Whatever it happens to be. And you just leave it there. Or you pick it up, put it in your inventory, and never look at it again. Well, anything you find up there, bring it down to be role-played with. There are smiths that can look at the ores that you come back with, if you have that ability, of course. And there are rare metals. Yes. Just because, if you find a thing, no matter what it is, role play it out. Bring it to the mages. Bring it to the smiths. Bring it to your guild leader. Maybe your guild leader will be able to tell you who to go talk to. All right. Now, some of you have come down and came straight to me. I'm not going to role play with you about it. Unless you are a blood knight or my familiar standing behind me on my left. Not because I don't like you. The reason is that it's designed to role play. Okay? And if you bring it to me every single time, yes, I do have my Game Master hat and my Magician hat. But it bypasses all the potential role play if you come to me and say, what did I get? No, I'm not going to play that game with you. I will send you to go talk to someone else. Now, obviously, my own assassins, I'm going to role play with them if they choose to do so. If they want to bring it to me, I will role play with them on that. Or my familiar. And yes, that does give them a slight advantage because I know what all the stuff is. I designed it and I had it put all out there. So yes, that does. But with great power comes great responsibility. Everybody that you see run around there that's level 5 or is a magister or a magister apprentice or a blood knight or my apprentice or my familiar over here. Now they work hard for me. Because I know I'm not a taskmaster. I try to do everything myself. But every single attempt I have made to grow extra arms has failed. It's really messy. So I have had to ask others to step up, join the conclave, join the cause. But what's the cause? Does anyone know? I mean, there's the IC cause, so the villains. But what's the cause? Why are we all here? No one. That's right. Red Magister answered the question immediately. It is to have fun. That is why we're here. Okay? I do my best to provide that for everyone. But I am as far from perfect as is possible. So, I have my magisters. Red Magister is Argalant. White Magister is Ivy Paderborn. Black Magister is Vark Ort. Okay? I have my Magister Apprentices. Salich, right in front of me here, is a Magister Apprentice. So is Zoskia, who I right currently cannot see. I don't know if he's here or not. Is also a Magister Apprentice. We've had, over the years, I've had a variety of different members in the Conclave. Yes, it is his birthday, that's right. It is his birthday. I sent him a happy birthday. I don't know if he got it. And it's Zoskia's birthday. I also have judges who spend, who give up their time to help everyone else have fun. And dungeon masters who give up their time to help everyone have fun. Yes. Jackie Stardancer. Nifredil, who I was just talking about earlier, is also a judge. The Red Magister right down in front that has been answering questions. He is also a dungeon master. Okay. You can be you can rest assured, if they're a magister, they are also a dungeon master. And it, because it's kind of a thing. Now, that shows that they have a lot of responsibility, doesn't it? Has anyone sat through any of the Deep Roads classes, knows anything that my dungeon masters and my judges do, in addition to what they do on the battlefield? So those DMs have a lot of responsibility. And that does not even include what I do, what kind of responsibility they have outside of that. They are my boots on the ground when I am not here. Okay? I'm here as often as I can be. But, like all of you, I have duties and responsibilities outside as well. Now, I teach. I have 3 kids. I'm a single father. I have a thing. I have a few things. And I drive an hour and a half each way to go to work. So, it is time consuming. So, yeah, humans. more of those than you want to know. Anyway. So I have the Conclave. I have my Dungeon Masters. I have my Judges. I have my Blood Knights out there getting information, collecting information. Yeah, occasionally they have to kill people, but you know, hey, that's part of the thing, right? And then, of course, you know, I have my Familiar over here to my left. And she fulfills multiple functions. Killing people is only one of them. Now, on top of all that, that's true. On top of all that, I have my monsters, my NPC monsters. Dungeon crawls are cool, right? It sounds like fun, right? Without monsters, dungeon crawls are not near as awesome. Yes, there are a lot of traps. You can still die. You can fall into a pit and remain there forever. There are, even without monsters, there are ways that you can be stuck and would not be particularly awesome. But monsters are what makes the dungeon crawls unique, okay? So, any of you out there that have played a monster for me, or know someone who has, or wants to, any of you who want to, or know someone who wants to, I encourage you to contact Mershon, aka Strangel Magic. She is in charge of all of my monsters, my NPCs. Now, that does not mean your main, okay? I don't want my Eve suddenly saying, okay, I want to play a villain, and suddenly, you know, she shows up in the Deep Roads as a monster. No, no, no. The monsters are alts that you make, okay? They are creatures of that fight the heroes. Now, when I say heroes, I don't only mean light forces. I also mean shadow forces. Because the forces of chaos, they don't just want to kill the light side. They don't just want to kill the shadow side. They don't just want to kill. They want to annihilate everything. Everything. That doesn't just mean people. That means everything. They want it all. Okay? Heroes are those who stand up against bad. And it doesn't mean if you, it doesn't. I'm not only talking about people with lawful good alignment. Is Pelinor in the room? No. All right. Pelinor is a paladin. Lawful good paladin. When I talk about heroes, I'm not only talking about a lawful good, you know, holier than thou, cross the street and I'll smack you upside the head. Oops, that was jaywalking. I'm not talking about that. Okay? It includes paladins like that. Okay? It also includes chaotic evil demonologists like Deenan. Oh yeah, okay, so he's not a nice guy, right? But he's still qualifies on the hero side, because as long as you are fighting the good fight, you're a hero. Dryder just entered the room. This is perfect. Perfect example. Okay. Now you look over that Dryder and you think, oh, well, she's a bad guy, right? That's definitely a villain. No, no, no. Let me tell you something. All of my blood knights are dryders. You don't see them. You see them walking around looking normal. But that they can shift into dryders. What you, the form you see is what they want you to see, because that's the way they were born. But their bloodline allows them to be dryders. Alright, now look over that Dryder to your, look over at that Dryder there. Now she looks scary, right? It does not make her a villain. Any Dryder that you come across is on your side. Now, it doesn't mean that a time won't, could not come where you are against a Dryder, not my blood knights, but you know, a Dryder in general. But ostensibly, that is the case. When the third Spider Squid Wars occurred, the Driders were the ones who all died in the final defense of the Dark Elven Empire. They sacrificed their lives so that the Dark Elves could survive. Gave the magician time to figure out the spell that would stop the Metaliki. So as a reward for their sacrifice, when the new magician rose, all Driders were made into Blood Knights. Or all Blood Knights were made into Driders? Who knows, right? So, but that brings up the second one, right? Alts. When you make an alt, or if you make an alt for the Deep Roads to play a villain, there's a vast array of possibilities. Okay? Lizard men are relatively common up there. So that's always welcome. Kuatoa are always welcome up there. That's piranha people, for those of you that don't know what that is. Troglodytes, which is like a cross between a caveman and a lizard man. Trolls, ogres, and that's not even touching the vast array of chaos beings, such as the Illithid, or beholders, or Grell, okay? And then, of course, there are the Metaliki. Now, Metaliki are metal people. All right? They are constructs that were originally designed by the Mind Flayers as foot soldiers to destroy the Dark Elven Empire. She'll be back. She crashed. Don't worry. And the Metaliki. So if you can imagine, from day one of your birth, you were kept in a cage and only allowed out to kill, to learn how to kill and kill well. Would that make you a good guy? No. The Metaliki were born and bred to kill, to annihilate, to destroy. Now they have souls, okay? They have souls, so they could each individually be a person, okay? Because they are constructs, they are golems, they have souls. But, you know, sure, there's a lot to it, but they could be people, but they weren't allowed to be people. From birth, they were trained to kill. So if you come across Metaliki, not only do they have massive armor, magic resistance, mega weapons, but they are also full of hate. Okay? Now you may think, oh, well, you know, I have my god is the god of hate. All right? So I understand hate. No, no, no. You don't even understand the God of hate. I mean, God of hate doesn't even understand how much hate Metallica I have. All right? They are constantly seeing red. All right? So, I know I have a few in here that worship the God of hate. And because there is a drow God of hate. In some places, I mean, he has a bunch of different names. Silvartum, Inurok, a few other names. But even he does not fathom the depth of hate that Metallica have. Okay. Reprogramming. Thank you for bringing that up. That was very intelligent. And I will not answer your statement, Sir Oust. I can go farther with that one. But let's say, okay, can they be reprogrammed? If you get a Metallici that has not been kept in a cage and taught to hate their whole lives, yeah, they can be normal people. Okay? They're metal. They're never going to stop being metal. But they can have emotions. I mean, if you can feel hate, that means you can feel love, right? Anyone disagree with that? If you can feel hate, that means you can feel love. So, yes, it is distinctly possible for them to be reprogrammed. But not the ones that have had all these 100,000 years, 200,000 years, 500,000 years. Not the ones that have spent every day for the past 200,000 years learning to hate. You can't reprogram them. Okay? You cannot reprogram them. But you can reprogram. You can program them, a Metallica, to be a standard being. They're always going to be metal. But they can be. They can act just like everyone else. They can learn to love. Yes. They can be successful contributing members of society. Okay. But the ones that have spent their whole existences hating, no, you cannot reprogram them. But the race is not lost. Yes, that's right. Because they do have a heart. Thank you for bringing that up, actually. Metallici have a heart. It is called a power core. That power core functions off of souls. Okay. That soul is wiped clean when it's put in there. And it becomes a new being. It doesn't matter if it was a demon, a celestial, a human, an elf, a monkey. It doesn't matter. It's wiped clean. And it starts fresh when it becomes a Metallica. None of the memories, none of the alignments, nothing that existed before exists now. They are new. And when you're new, you start over, right? Tabula rasa. Okay. Now, for those that are full of hate, that's, they could have been an angel beforehand. They could have been a celestial. It doesn't really, what they were beforehand is not significant. Okay? What they are now is what matters. They cannot be reprogrammed if they are already a 200,000 years of hate. But they can be programmed. You cannot reprogram one of the beings that has been doing this for 200,000 years. You can't program a new one. New ones can be trained to be contributing members of success of society, but the enemies are completely lost cause. There is nothing you cannot get through. Okay, it is over and done with them. So, could they defect? Yes. Will they defect? No. It's not possible. Every one of you. All right, in your real life, you have, you know, 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, 60 years. All right, in that amount of time, see, that is a drop in the bucket compared to a Metaliki. They have spent your lifetime 1,000 times over in hate. So you get that. Alright? Now if you spend 10 years in pure hate, then would anybody be able to change you? No. Think about that times 100,000. Okay. Yeah. So, I'm sorry. No. You cannot reprogram one that's already out there. But, the race has hope. Because should you gain the ability to have Metaliki not raised in hate, they can be just like everyone else. Act like everyone else. They're still going to be made of metal. Okay? But they can be just like everyone else. Okay. Any questions on all of that? Now, since I am teaching another class at 2, and I want to slip outside and... Okay. I think I see myself. All right, there we go. Okay. Now, yeah, I am going to step out for a smoke for a second. But before I do that, the arrival of Jalil Liar. I saw her appear for a second there. Are you still there? Or did she crash? Yeah, there she is. Okay. Her arrival brought something to mind that I wanted to bring up. The tavern, the Lion's Head Tavern. For everyone who wants to go on a Deep Roads run, two things. Number one, there's a sign up in the back of the tavern. I probably will move that because I'm thinking about setting up an extra office back there. Then we'll have to figure out how we're going to do it. Or, you know, maybe I'll just move it over. But it has been suggested that I bring an office down to Earth also. And then for times when, so that people can actually reach me. So I'm thinking about that, dude. I'm thinking about doing that. And should I do so, it'll be out there on the patio. Okay. Anyway. So two things. Number one, the sign-up list is in the tavern, Lion's Head Tavern. The second thing, the Lion's Head Tavern is full of individuals that can take OOC information, like there's going to be a Deep Roads run on this day, that blah, 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 blah. They can tell you those things. All right, they have access to changing OOC information to IC information. All right. Yeah, I'm going to set up down about where the cork board is now. So probably move the cork board on the opposite side of the porch. And I'll just take that corner over there just for times when, I don't know. We'll see. We'll look down there. Anyway. All the members of the bar can do that. Now, Gage Collingsgrove has a special ability given by me, that allows him to do so. But that special ability includes all of his staff. He is the general manager for the Lion's Head Tavern. Okay? But everybody in the Lion's Head's effectively working for me. Okay? And he also has two managers, an orc and a Doc Alfar. The orc is the day manager. And the assistant manager for the whole, the assistant general manager is, she's down there sometimes too. And I'm terrible because for some reason her name's escaping me right this very second. And that shows bad things. Anyway. You can ask anybody else in the tavern. She's got Katamari. Katamari is one of the bar staff. What's the name of the girl? Geisha is the day manager. Okay. And that's correct. Geisha is the day manager. That's not who I meant. And the night manager is basically Marie. No, it's the Levina. Ta. I remember. Sometimes, hey, it takes a while, right? But we get there. All right. The assistant general manager is Levina Webb. Yes. Varys also. So there are several. There are several members of the Lion's Head Tavern that can do such thing. Yes, that's correct. Mary, she's the night manager. Geisha is the day manager. Levina Webb is the assistant general manager. Gage is the general manager. And then the baker is Adriana Lyer, who's right over here to our right. She's the one who does all your cooking for you. Cantino makes coffee. and then, of course, myself, who I'll set up an office down there. Anyway, my point is, if you want OOC information, you can go in there. They all have the ability to take OOC information and make it IC. Oh yes, Adriana Lyer, right there, the baker. You know, she makes pies, cookies, cakes. Oh, something else, let me tell you. Do I have any wolves in this room? Well, besides Argument. And actually, he counts. Everything that she makes, whether you're a vampire, a demon, a wolf, an elf, or a human, is effective to you, okay? Even if what you feed on is souls, you could go and get a chocolate cookie from her, and it will, because of the magic oven I gave her, everything she cooks will feed you just like what you are used to eating, whether it's a live rabbit or a human soul. It's going to give you that same satisfaction, that same feeding. Yes, even blood for vampires. It doesn't matter what it is. It makes it so that no matter what you eat from her, it's going to give you all that same satisfaction, the same sustenance, the same feeling as though you were feeding on what you normally do. Okay, so do not discount her pies when you see them in the, she's in the Lion's Head Tavern. Adriana, you say something so people know who you are. She's a redhead over here on my right. She's the royal baker. All right. Alright, now, yes, so she has a magic oven. She can feed anyone, doesn't matter what you like. Yeah, maybe she doesn't have ears on. So, someone tell her I just told everybody about her. Now I'm going to slip out for a second, alright? So when people show up, let them know that I'm just out for a second, and class will start as soon as I return. We will go into the class on Dark Elves as soon as I return. Okay? Baldos, for your attendance, I do hope you remain for the second half of the class, and that you call in all your Dark Elven brethren. Vendos for now.